Okay, good afternoon. My name is Muhammad Awad. I'm a clown, but I am not an average clown. I consider myself to be a teacher clown. Now you might ask yourself, what is a teacher clown? And what is the reason I'm talking to you at the moment? Simply, a teacher clown is a human being who wears a red nose but chooses not to go to birthday parties, not to go to public events where children are wearing the best dresses and people are celebrating a baptism or a birthday or whatever festival around the world it is. The teacher clown's job is to bring reconciliation, healing, whether it's psychological, mental, or even social healing among the people, and especially the children who come from what we call the crisis area. When I speak about crisis area, we're talking about the young refugees, we're speaking about the children who suffer from the loss of their parents for some reason, also the children who suffer from the chronic diseases and the cancer, all these crisis area that could really bring a big toll on the minds and the hearts of the people. All these reasons, we find it as a clowns a very good excuse where we can have intervention. Our intervention comes through laughter and play. We use play and play therapy through clowning, entertainment and fun as a way to make the people look at life in a positive way. Whenever there is a conflict, whenever there is a struggle, whether it's social, political, weak, or even health struggle, we really find the people in their weakest points to communicate with themselves or to communicate with the others. Here comes the role of the clown, where we say that we are just human beings and we can take things to basics. A clown is a very basic human being who takes everything around the world in a very, very simple manner. Think of Mr. Bean that we all grew up with. Think of Robin Williams in Patch Adams. We use very simple techniques. It's the technique of laughter, this technique of making fun of ourselves, of our defaults, teaching ourselves to accept ourselves this the way we are, no matter what mistakes that we do, no matter the weaknesses that we have. We can just take it, accept it, and sometimes, yes, making fun of it. It's a way that the clowns do in order to reach to a concept of acceptance and not taking things, not making things carry burden more than it deserves. This is the job of the teacher clown. It is an educator. The clown is mostly an educator. It teaches us about ourselves, about loving ourselves and allowing ourselves to take life in a more easy manner. This can help us all as children, as adults, to look at life in a bright side. It's a very, very important element in a human mind and human psychology, where we take all the time our life seriously, ending up having a big struggle to approaching the world or to connecting with the world. Rather, we'd rather take things simple, beautiful, and with a big smile, and then showing the world that we can really go forward together, one step at a time, through some kind of smile that could develop a laughter. And that's even a very beautiful approach to communicate in a healthy way. That is the power that the clown could use in his daily life. It's a form of theater, it's a form of drama in education, art in education, call it what you say. And it is very common, a school of education that has been all around Europe, North America, in also Southern America, especially Brazil and East Asia as well, where many theater and drama practitioners use clowning as a way to educate people about social, psychological, mental, and health issues, and to approach it in a more positive and simple way. That's basically what my job is. I thank you for giving me your time, and if you feel you have any question to ask, I will be so happy to answer them. In peace and love. Have a good evening.